she had an Olympic dream for herself and for Russia. But in the early days of Sydney, the dream grew dark for Yelena Zamolachikova. But out of her tears would come a gift, a second chance given by a teammate. Svetlana Horkina gave up her spot in the vault finals so Zamo could go for gold. One day later, she won another gold on the floor. That darkest hour had turned into dawn. Today, Zamo takes her first step toward Athens in 2004. Sydney was not kind to America's Blaine Wilson. His dreams of an Olympic medal simply blown away. Now his road to redemption leads to Athens, and the five-time national champion is still America's best, still loaded with confidence, still doing gymnastics his way. Today, Blaine Wilson takes his first step toward 2004 in the American Cup. And we are live inside the TD Waterhouse Center in downtown Orlando. The long Olympic journey begins again in the prestigious 26th Visa American Cup. A total of 14 Olympians on hand here from around the world. They've gathered in this elite field. I'm Dan Hicks with Tim Daggett, Elfie Schlegel, and Beth Ruyak. And included in the elite field is Blaine Wilson, the man who won this American Cup competition three straight times before sitting out last year after recovering from the shoulder surgery. And even with the Sydney disappointment, Tim, based on all his credentials, he is the man to beat here.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that. The biggest struggles that Blaine Wilson is going to have, along with everybody else throughout the competition, you're going to hear this over and over again, is the new code of points and a skill on the pommel horse that is an addition, is a requirement. It's a scissor skill. You have to do it at least B level element, and it's right here. He adds this to his routine because he has to, not because he wants to. And he stumbles a little bit right there. This is his first event. But just like Blaine Wilson typically always does, somehow he finds a way to grab onto that equipment and keep going.
He was in third place after a little bit of a disappointing beginning to the horse. Got into second place after the floor exercise. And as Tim mentioned, they're now in the third rotation. And this was Blaine Wilson earlier in his strength a few moments ago in the rings, trying to take over the lead from his teammate Sean Townsend.
Last quadrennium we said that strength was the key on rings. It was everything. Well, it's even more important now, and this is where Wilson shines. He is so physically strong relative to his body size. He can just hold his body in perfect positions just like that.
And Tim, this was one of the events that he said would be easiest for him to adapt to the new rules.
Every 4 years, typically, the rules change. And every gymnast and coach out there, they're just waiting. Oh my gosh, is this going to be good for me? When Blaine saw the ring code, he went, this is a walk in a park for me.
So it was a solid performance on the rings as expected for Blaine Wilson. As you look at Blaine live now, there is the ring score, 9.65. So that puts Blaine into the lead for the moment. Again, Sean Townsend and others still yet to go in their third rotation. But you're now looking at the men's standings after two rotations. And there was Wilson in that second spot, right behind his teammate Sean Townsend. Alexander Berish currently in third from Ukraine. And now our first look at Crystal Uzelak, just 14 years old. And Elfie, this is America's most promising fresh face, the two-time junior national champion, but this is a big step up. This is her biggest meet so far.
And she admitted to being a tad bit nervous because she knows what the American Cup is all about. It's big time.
Line landing, but wow. And that is what you want to see, especially first time out in a major competition like this. Blind landing, she just keeps her composure. She's actually a little bit under-rotated in the air, kind of makes an adjustment, bends her knees slightly before landing, and just holds on and sticks it.
And you mentioned the bent knees in the air, Tim. That's the experience of being in an American Cup. She needs this competition to see how she can relate to the pressures and being in the same arena as Olympians. There you see the form break.
A little bit of a camouflage there, because if she does that vault in a tuck position, it's going to get a lower start value. I think the judges are still going to give it to her in pike. She's able to hold on and stick it. That's the critical thing.
Again, this is the first of four rotations for the women.
She'll make this more complicated on her second run. The women in this competition have to do two different vaults. They will take both of them, average them, and that will be their score.
Just 14 years old, by far the youngest gymnast here. The next is 16 years old. Her first vault to score 9.05 for Usalak, and by far really the smallest gymnast here as well.
Crystal said one of her greatest assets is that she is always focused in competition.
Adds a half turn right here.
Wow.
Pretty solid start for Usalak in the big time competition.
Much better second ball. You see the cleaner legs in the air. Doesn't stick the landing. Coach Bill Strauss right there, and he says he's a little bit like her grandpa.
Now on the still range
and
from
the women's competition over to the rings, and what a start it was, Tim, by Sean Townsend, who you said you described his floor exercise, which was the very first event here, the very first with the new quarter points. It's just astounding. Here he is on the rings.
Probably will never do a routine like that again. It's hard to believe. Once again, strength is everything, though.
Needs better than a 9.625 to take over the lead.
And I just really don't think that that's possible. He can get a good score. They brought back the Iron Cross, a saving grace in men's gymnastics. It was devalued. Much of the last code of points really didn't get you any bonus points. It's a very good exercise for Sean, though. Here comes the dismount, full twisting double layout. Yeah, a great thing. So far, first time out, new code of points. Sean Townsend, best meet of his life.
Well, it was Blaine Wilson who predicted a 1-2 finish between himself and Townsend, and whatever order we get at the end, who knows, it could be Townsend looking very strong in the early going. Meanwhile, the score, the average of the first two vaults for Usalak, 9.287, so it's a good start for the young 14-year-old trying to prove herself among the world's elite. And still to come, Yelena Zamolachikova, the gold medalist in the floor in the vault from the 2000 games in Sydney, and the clear-cut favorite here in the women's competition in the 2001 Visa American Cup. And this Visa American Cup is brought to you by Visa. It's everywhere you want to be. By Hershey's Chocolate Bar. Hershey's, put a smile on your face. And by Geico Direct, the sensible alternative. We're back live at the Visa American Cup in downtown Orlando. As you look at Sean Townsend, who has just turned in a score of 9.525 in the ring, so Blaine Wilson does regain his top spot. Stays at the top in the men's competition. And now our first look at Yelena Zamolachikova. And for obvious reasons, Tim and Elfie, I know you referred to her as Zamo in Sydney. We're going to go in this meet from here on out, Zamo.
We're going with
that
Zamo.
That works with you guys.
But by far the most impressive gymnast here at this meet. We mentioned earlier that she is the clear-cut favorite and really a huge favorite in this discipline. She's the reigning world champion in the vault.
And that's one of the reasons right there, one of the top difficulties that you're seeing in this competition, that particular vault is out of a 9.9.
And we won't see anything near that level here. She needs only a 9.193 to move into first place. Head coach Leonid Arkayev from Russia, not here. Her personal coach making the trip along with her, Nadia Maslenkova.
And that is really like a mother-daughter relationship. Aslanikova has been with her since she began gymnastics at age 7.
Just a little bit of form in the air, you see that, but this vault is so difficult, so hard, that that's really not going to hurt her. On the men's side, the great equalizer right now in the Coda points is the Still Rings. Right now, it's women's vault. Mm-hmm. You've got to do two different vaults in this level of competition. They have to be different, so she's going to do something completely from a different family right here, and you've got to average them.
And this event for women is probably the most difficult for any of them to score near a 10.0. There are very few vaults that are out of a start value of 10.0.
There's the score in the first vault, 9.512.
This one, a simple vault for her. Yurchenko double twist.
Beautiful vault, just that hop forward on the landing, but there's no question she's going to emerge from round one here as the leader.
And there is Nadia Maslenikova, who has been with Zamo since day one.
Really remarkable. She started her Sydney Olympics out. It looked so bleak for her up until the very end, the event finals, and then everything just came together.
And this particular vault that she's doing in this competition has actually been devalued since the Olympic Games. It was originally a 9.9 vault. Now it's only a 9.8. Does it very well, with the exception of that tiny hop.
So Zamo off to a pretty solid start, as we expected. And we've talked a lot about the new Coda points, Dan Hicks with Elfie Schlegel and Tim Daggett, and that really leads us to talk about who is not here. First, let's talk about the Chinese. Tim, they have been to the American Cup in recent years, but where are they this year?
Well, actually, obviously, as you know, they are the Olympic champions. They won the team championship for the first time. They're not here. They said they need 3 months, a minimum of 3 months, to prepare with this new Coda points. They were actually convinced to travel to Hawaii for a team competition that'll come up later on down the road for NBC Sports.
Well, it was Zamo's Russian team, which finished behind the Romanian women in the team gold competition in Sydney. So the Romanian women are not here.
Well, and the Romanian women are really in the same boat. Everyone's using that same excuse, if you will, about not being ready for the new Coda points. And quite frankly, they're the Olympic champions. They're not about to send anyone to the United States if they're not going to win the meet.
I mean, in simplest terms, can you put this Coda points into perspective? I mean, this is probably your worst college exam.
Hard.
Experts like
yeah,
you
hard.
Who exactly. have to take a
Very
look
hard.
At this thick pamphlet and try to decipher it.
Well, the amazing thing is it's not just what came out just a few months ago. There are constant revisions, constant changes, and even worse than that, interpretation. So all over the world, you saw the coaches when they got into the floor for the first time. Everybody's talking to everybody about the Coda points, and they're saying, well, what do you think this is? What if you do this with this element? What's it going to be? So it's an interpretation of the rules as well. That's the tricky part.
Elfie, how many hours of late night reading
oh,
did you put in?
Let me tell you, it almost took close to the Olympics to learn that new Coda points in the last quadrennium. So this is a tough road with this one.
Well, you need every 4 years to try to recover from reading the new Coda points. As you look at Blaine Wilson, the current leader, three-time champion already in the Visa American Cup. And we will see Blaine on the vault when we return to the TD Waterhouse in downtown Orlando. There is the leader in the women's competition at the 26th Visa American Cup, Yelena Zamolachikova. Zamo, as expected, at the top of the women's standings after the first of four rotations for them. Monica Bergamelli of Italy is in second place. Laura Martinez of Spain is in third. And the Americans, Ashley Kelly and Crystal Uzlak, occupy the third and fourth spots. And the men are through three of their rotations, and Blaine Wilson has taken over the lead from his teammate Sean Townsend, and it is Alexander Beresh of Ukraine who is in third place. Eric Lopez is the defending champion in this Visa American Cup. Got off to a poor start, was in eighth place after the second rotation, but has moved up to spot number five. And for more on him, here's Beth Ruyak. Beth.
Thank you, Dan. It's been a big year for Eric Lopez since that win. He says, in a way, it's been tough because it's now full of a lot of new responsibilities, the most significant of which was his first child, little Eric, born just 2 weeks ago today. Now, he is, because of all the events of the last year, one of the best gymnasts Cuba has ever produced. And Cuba continues to be his foundation and his home.
I don't know what to say. I can believe in myself. I never thought he would do so well.
When I was 8 or 9, I wanted to quit. But my mother and my brothers told me I couldn't and encouraged me to continue on with my training.
Last year was his third American Cup. Eric Lopez had never been in the top three, and no one expected him to do well.
For Eric Lopez, this is a gigantic day.
Let's say it another way. Eric Lopez rocked the place.
Eric Lopez is the Visa Cup champion.
What an athlete wants is to participate in the games. In the 96 Olympics, I didn't qualify, and that really motivated me to continue on and make it to Sydney. I was recently training for the American Cup, and some friends came to the gym to tell me that my wife was in labor. I rushed to the hospital, and she gave birth an hour later. It's my first son. It's overwhelming.
Well, Eric can't wait to give the word back to home in Havana, Cuba about how he does in this meet, but he's had a little bit of a problem with his telephone calling card, so he has not spoken to his wife. And I understand that Beth Rujak and company are going to help him out, maybe with a cell phone, to make sure that Eric's able to talk about what happened here in the defense of his American Cup.
You saw that pommel horse score. That was very unfortunate. He is actually very good, and if I had to pick an athlete before the competition began who was best suited for this new code of points without major changes to his program, it would have been Eric Lopez. If you looked at a lot of his routines, they just fit very well with the new code of points. Didn't have to make as many changes as the other athletes.
And that's exactly what Eric felt, Tim. He said that the new code in his mind was not difficult at all, and he felt that all athletes should just adapt to the new rules and not make a big deal about them, and that's certainly how he was treating things.
He was the first Cuban to win the American Cup, and certainly has etched his names in the annals of Cuban gymnastics. However, Tim Daggett, he's not the most prominent Cuban gymnast. You have to go back to a guy by the name of Casimir Suarez, who clearly is the greatest Cuban gymnast of all time. Lopez, second best, right?
That's right. You got to go way back to when I was competing, and that's a long time back. He was a fantastic gymnast. Eric, of course, three-time Pan American all-around champion. Big fall, 2.5 twists.
Wow.
Got that one.
Yeah.
Like I said, he really didn't have to. He didn't have to change his vault. He's been doing that thing for years. New code of points comes out. Everybody's making all these changes. Eric's just doing his same old stuff.
Again, Lopez trying to move up from the fifth spot in defense of his American Cup. And there is Ashley Kelly, who joins Yuzlak, one of the Americans here competing from Tulsa, Oklahoma. And a last-minute replacement in this field. She replaced Olympian Tasha Schweikert, and she found out in a very interesting way on Wednesday, actually surfing the internet, taking a look at the net site for usagymnastics.org, found out that she was going to be
here. Not the way that I would want to find out that I'm competing, especially at an American Cup. But, you know, her coach, Christy Kraft, said that when she told her, you know, you want to compete in the American Cup, don't you? She said, I don't know. What is it? She didn't even know what this competition was all about. But, you know, she said she's not here to win the competition. That's not going to happen. She's here to just gain experience. This is really only her second international event.
17 years old, Kelly, as you take a look at Lopez and the score for him. 9.6.
That's a big number on vaulting. That is going to be difficult to beat, but we have some of the best vaulters in the world at this year's American Cup.
There it is. So Lopez hopes to continue to move up from that eighth spot that she occupied after two rotations. And here is the 17-year-old from Tulsa, Oklahoma.
First time that we actually saw Ashley was last year at the international team event in Syracuse, New York. She was the leadoff person three times for the Americans, did her job. She's very focused.
There's a tricky part in the exercise. It comes right here into a release move. Right on.
Might be wondering why Tasha Schweikert, the 2000 Olympian did not come here, and that had to do with the, yes, the code of points again, feeling that she wasn't quite ready.
You know what, she's doing a great job, just as she did back in December.
Double laid out somersault.
A little close sometimes on that dismount.
But that is a great bar routine for Ashley Kelly.
Kelly in the fourth spot, tied with Uzlak. And there is Christy Krapp, Ashley Kelly's coach. They look happy. Now here's Blaine Wilson. You see what he's done so far in the first three rotations. Moved up into the first spot after that ring routine. Here he is on the vault.
Made finals, of course, at the Olympic Games on vault. Actually came into the finals with the highest score. This is big time gymnastics. Anytime you flip three times, how hard to put it to your feet.
Yeah.
Wow.
That vault just got more and more consistent over the year, last year, leading up to the Olympics.
Not bad.
You know, he predicted the sweep for the U.S., but of course he put himself in front of Sean Townsend, no problem.
Oh, Blaine says it's all about the cash here.
Cold cash.
This is a guy that has always spoken his mind. We asked him, why go on? He says, hey, there's some money at stake in this American
Cup. That's right. Three times around here from feet to feet. Actually has to pull and hold on a little longer than usual and meets that floor as hard as he can. That hop forward, going to be a big vault.
But Tim, the only sad thing is they devalued that vault by a couple of tenths.
Used to be out of a 10, now currently at a 9.8. Still going to bring in a big number. Blaine joking with his coach there about how he had to hold on to that tuck a little bit longer.
Ashley Kelly, happy after her uneven bars routine, 8.837. And next up is the teammate she's tied with after the first rotation, Uzlak. And in the words of Uzlak's coach, Donna Strauss, she says, of all the gymnasts we've been coaching through the years, I think this young lady will go all the way in the 2004 Olympics and be a very strong contender for the all-around. Well, now that's a long way away, but that's a pretty heady statement to make about a 14-year-old.
Says a lot about this young athlete, seeing how many great athletes the Parkettes have turned out over the years. She had some difficulty, however, yesterday in practice.
On this element,
just a little pause there.
This release right move here. Right here, no problem today. One of her best qualities is she is a fierce competitor, but that is going to cost her.
She hit the
ground, and then she is improvising right here. Dismount, double laid out somersault.
Crystal Uzlak, USA.
Usually a stone cold competitor, but now got through most of the toughest stuff, Alexei struggled a little bit in the beginning.
Well, and Bill and Donna Strauss had said that she's coming into this competition, this being probably her weakest event, one of the lowest start values that you're going to see in this competition. And, you know, struggled a little bit there. Again, it's going to take at least another year to get these routines down.
I asked Donna Strauss what she most wanted to get out of the way, and she said it was bars.
Well, it's out of the way, even though it was pretty shaky. And now the scores for Blaine Wilson in the vault, 9.5. So Blaine Wilson continues to look like perhaps he's on his way to his fourth American Cup title. And will it be the first American Cup title for Zamo? Yelena Zamolachikova of Russia. We'll see her continue her quest for that title when we come back.
For Zamo, gymnastics is not only for her, it is for Russia, a country badly in need of heroes. Her father, a Russian soldier, died last year of complications from the Chernobyl disaster. He would never see his daughter live out her dream. And like her Russian upbringing, Zamo's Olympic experience wouldn't be easy.
The team competition was a big disappointment for me. The silver medal is a big achievement for some, but not for Russia. the 4 years of my hard work and preparation, and then I didn't make it. It was like a nightmare.
While the Russian team would have to settle for silver, Zamo's opportunity for gold was still alive, thanks to the help of a friend.
Winning the 2 gold medals was the highlight of my career. It was like all my dreams came true.
Well, the Olympics are all about seizing the opportunity, and no one exemplified that more in Sydney than Zamo, now Russia's true gymnastic star, Alfie.
Yeah, she actually had great opportunities in Australia. She only really made it into the event finals on the floor exercise. The other two events in the all-around was actually handed over to her because of an injured teammate, as well as the vault finals when Horkina stepped back and allowed the reigning world champion to win a medal.
She not only won the gold in the floor exercise in the vault, was figuring to win the all-around gold as well. I mean, she had the vault. That was her last and best event. That was preceded by the floor exercise. All of a sudden, she took a seat and everybody gasped.
Yeah, she stumbled on an event, on an element that is really easy for her. It was hers to take.
Okay, back over to the men's competition. Alexander Berish on the vault. And he takes a seat.
And when you see this vault done and made over and over again, and then you see a guy like Berish who's done this many, many times,
yeah,
but just doesn't have enough
to
make it around, it is no easy task.
Berish took the bronze in the all-around at the 2000 Olympics, while his Ukrainian team took the silver.
Just not enough oomph to get this all the way around. Doesn't have the rotation that he needs, and opens up just a little bit early. And that's big time, 5/10. See ya.
Berish trying to stay close to the Americans, Wilson and Townsend, but most likely will fall further behind Wilson and Townsend, who you look at right now.
And I'll tell you, first event, first guy up in the entire competition, first major routine done with these new code of points in the world, and it was on floor exercise, and he will do this routine for the next 4 years, and I don't think he'll ever do it any better than he did it the first time out. This is one of these 5/10 passes, upgraded it, had to make it a lot more difficult. It ends with a double front somersault.
So much more exciting to see an element like this on men's floor exercise.
And then Kerpow, just like that. Don't move those feet.
Feels good.
Kerpow?
Feels good.
That's in the new quota points in the broadcasting category.
Well, you know, both Sean and Blaine felt that they had the upper hand coming into this American Cup. They'd been watching the practices, and they felt they were more prepared than any of the other gymnasts.
Yeah, they're right. They're right. Looking at the international field, these athletes, they really haven't upgraded. They haven't adapted to the new code as well as the two Americans. Same vault we've seen from Blaine and from Barris right here. Just bring 2.5 front.
Oh, you know, he actually could do a much more difficult vault. As Coach Kevin was saying, that he just wasn't ready for this meet. But a more difficult vault with a higher start value, it's too bad, because he certainly had it today.
And that's what happens in the warm-up. Just a couple of minutes ago, Sean did the same vault, and he landed short on it. So he knows he's got to go a little bit harder, get up in the air a little bit more, and hold on to this tuck. It's just too long, and he shows full support.
That's unfortunate.
On his hands, and that is going to cost him substantially.
At the Olympic Games, he absolutely nailed this vault in the first day of team competition.
But that's the first disappointment here today for Sean Townsend.
After that incredible start of the floor exercise.
It's gonna be enough, though, to certainly keep him in second position at this point. The Americans have just such a huge lead over the rest of the international field.
Looking like Blaine Wilson's prediction is going to come through. 1-2 for the Americans. Back over to the women's competition as you look at Zamo getting ready for the bars.
She's actually going to unveil a mount that is super, super difficult. You won't see a mount like that in this competition. It's valued at E, which is one of the more difficult elements, but the women have now included what's called Super E elements. And if they do an element of a Super E value, it gives them 3/10, which is huge. The men have already done this in the last code of points. And the women are following suit with the same type of skill.
The further into the alphabet that you go, the harder the element, A's being the easiest.
Before Zamo gets up on the bars, the score for Townsend, 9.15, should be good enough to keep him in second.
It's going to keep him in second, no question about that. Each one of the gymnasts has their own personal liking to the way.
Oh, Zamo took a fall there. Is that going to cost her?
You know, it's really sad when she has to do her own bars, prepare her own bars. The Russians typically sand them clean.
And then they have this.
Well, nothing's ever easy for these Russians training. I mean, things have gotten a lot better for Zamo through the years, especially after the success she had in Sydney. But she once trained in a gym without a full-size vault runway or a full-size floor exercise mat. In fact, when she practiced the vault, she started in the entry hallway, went out a couple of doors that were opened, and into the practice vault.
It's hard to believe.
I mean, it gives you extra appreciation for what these Russian athletes are able to accomplish with the conditions and the tough livelihoods that many of them go through.
But you know, she's really relaxed here at this competition. In fact, the other day in practice, we found out she wasn't anywhere near the practice, and we were wondering where the heck she was. She was left at the mall. They actually forgot to pick up her coach and herself from a shopping mall. They made their way back for the last 15 minutes of practice. Yesterday in practice, she only showed up for one. She's made shopping a priority on this trip because she knows she's very confident in her routines.
And I'll tell you, only a two-time double gold medal winner in the Olympic Games can make the judges wait that much and not incur the wrath.
Take a look at this mount. Well, she changed it.
What was she going to do?
And she was going to do something pretty wild. Let me tell you, I wouldn't want to do it.
But her routine, very similar to what we've seen from her in the past. This sequence, she has performed many times, the releases in a row.
One thing that she does do in this bar routine is she shows a great variety of skills, and that's something that the judges are looking for. That was easy for her.
Not only so solid technically, talented obviously, but just has a great presence out there on the floor. Zamo Lajikova continues her quest for the American Cup title. We'll be right back to Orlando in a moment.
Sunday, a two-hour special event, The Best of the West Wing.
Welcome to the White House.
Catch two episodes. Viewers voted the best of the most honored show on television.
Nothing like surrounding yourself with the best and the brightest.
A special Sunday West Wing event.
This is a great job.
The Best of the West Wing. NBC Sunday, 9, 8 Central.
Back live at the Visa American Cup. There is Zamo, the leader after the first rotation, and after a bar routine of 8.937, looking to take that as well.
Well, you got to remember, once again, these athletes used to start out at a 9.0. Now they've got to get two more tenths, and they made everything more difficult. They've added special requirements. A lot of these athletes just, they, frankly, they're not prepared at this point. It's just a little bit too early.
And you can see Zamo look at the score as if, wow, that doesn't seem too high. But who knows? Could that end up being the top score?
I hopefully not. I'd like to think not. But remember, she removed that very difficult mount, which would have given her another two tenths. And remember, the women are starting at 8.8 now, not 9.0 like they did in the last cycle.
You mentioned the cash available for Blaine Wilson. If a woman sweeps the competition, as Zamo has the only chance to do that, that would be worth $19,000 to her.
That's a big payday.
And this is 16-year-old Laura Martinez. And if you were to handicap this Visa American Cup beforehand, of course go with Zamo the favorite. Maybe Martinez with the best chance to push her in the competition?
Yeah, I'd say so. She 13th in the all-around in 2000, the Olympic Games. And I'll tell you, the whole story about Spain, though, was the gigantic upset that they made over the home team, the Australians, to make it into the team finals. They were in the last round, and that team, they were just phenomenal. And
came down to the last vaulter. It was so exciting.
Laura Martinez, a huge part of that team.
And actually, they've only lost one athlete from their Olympic team. Jesus Carballo, the head coach, has said that the team has remained the same pretty much, with the exception of that one athlete. This young lady is planning to continue on to 2004.
Well, she's just 16, and Martinez was in third behind Zamo and Bergamelli of Italy after the first rotation.
We're going to see a little bit of a different style with Laura. She's really changed her bar routine quite drastically from the Olympic Games. You'll see an element called a stalder, and that is a move that was quite popular back in the late 70s and the 80s. She actually does that a number of times in her routine.
A gymnast named Amy Chow did quite a few of those in her routine. There are these straddle elements right here, and they are very encouraged in the Coda points, but as you can see right here, not as practiced as they need to be at this point. Oh. Working very nicely, a little bit slow here and there.
One of the judges actually pointed out the use of the stalders that she's done in this bar team could be looked at as a little bit of overuse. They're trying not to encourage the athlete.
Beautiful dismount.
Pretty nifty dismount.
And a great landing.
Yeah, she's having a great American Cup.
And the smiles tell it all for Laura Martinez.
This includes the competition.
She and the rest of these gymnasts try to continue to put the chase on Yelena Zamolachikova. We'll take a break here from the Gymnastics in Orlando and send you to New York at the Sun America Sports Desk with Ahmad Rashad.
Prepare to march to their next event.
Dan Hicks back with Tim Daggett, Elfie Schlegel, and Beth Ruiak as we continue our live coverage of the 26th Visa American Cup. As you look at the leader for the women, Zamolachikova. But Zamo now has company, and it comes in the form of Laura Martinez, the 16-year-old from Spain, who turned in a pretty good performance in the uneven bar. As you can see now that she is just 6/1000ths of a point behind Zamo. Ashley Kelly of the United States in the third spot. Uzlak of the United States has dropped to the fifth spot. And there is Blaine Wilson, who currently leads with the men, also left with a couple of rotations. We take a look at their standings. Sean Townsend still right behind him. Wilson has opened up just a little less than a half point lead, and it's Dragulescu of Romania who is in the third spot as Wilson tries to win his fourth American Cup title. Well, last September in Sydney, Blaine Wilson's script to Olympic stardom seemed to be written. Instead, the storyline changed dramatically in an almost cruel manner.
The hype was relentless, and by the Olympic trials, Blaine Wilson was America's hope.
Blaine Wilson, who continues to display an absolute state of readiness for the Olympic Games.
I predict this guy's gonna come home with a medal in the all-around, maybe even a gold one.
If he doesn't medal in Sydney, it would be such a disappointment for as good as he's been for so long.
Qualifying for the team competition is the start for a strong American contingent, and the best among them is Blaine Wilson, who could be the top U.S. male gymnast in the last two decades.
Even Blaine knew what was at stake.
You could either be a hero or you could be a chump. I mean, that's what it's going to come down to.
But in the end, the trip down under plunged Blaine Wilson into depths of unprecedented disappointment.
Here we go.
No way.
Some of the mistakes that I made at the Olympic Games were mistakes that I've never made before in my life. People don't realize that Olympians spend their time for 4 years and they get one shot to win a medal. I knew what I had to do. I just couldn't get it done at that time. I think it was just fate, and that's why I'm still sitting in this chair right here.
So Blaine is still around, but will fate take him on a third Olympic journey?
Who knows, I might be around until 2004, I might not, but at this point, I'm just gonna take it year by year, and I'm not ready to get a real job yet.
Blaine Wilson has accomplished everything you could possibly imagine here in the United States. On the international stage, Tim Daggett, he's come up well short.
Yeah, it has not happened for him outside of American Cup and some other competition. He was a legitimate contender, not just to win a medal, but to come home with even the gold. As I said, and as he said, he made mistakes that he never did before. It was a little bit weird.
Well, he said to me here that it was such a grind that last year of the Olympics, particularly the last month, and he said he won't start out this Olympic cycle by promising people that he'll be there in 2004.
Kind of a familiar Olympic refrain, if you will, from a number of athletes. You know, the old put too much pressure on myself, I'm gonna take it month by month. But do you believe we'll see Blaine in 2004?
Well, I believe that you'll see him most definitely at the World Championships in 2001. And a lot of whether or not we see him in Athens will be, is he successful in 2001? I think if he wins a medal in the all-around, or the team, I'm not quite sure. I think he might bolt. That was a big parallel bar routine so early on in this code of points.
Nice
he just
job,
made
nice
that
job.
Look so doggone easy. Virtually every gymnast from around the world is struggling on P-bars because there are all these new requirements, and Blaine just gets the job done easy here.
All right, we shift over to the women's competition, to the balance beam. By the way, Ashley Kelly, Crystal Uzlak's teammate, just had a very impressive routine. So it looks like she'll continue to have the lead over Uzlak, who's been just a little bit disappointing so far, but still a lot of gymnastics left. And this is an event that she is very, very confident in.
Very confident and very strong. And in fact, she has one of the highest start values in this competition. I believe it's at a 10.0. If she hits everything, you know, this gymnastic club that she's from, the Parkettes, have just turned out a number of great athletes who have been fantastic on the balance beam.
But this routine is not just good by the code standards. It's also very interesting, very different, and truly difficult gymnastics like what you're gonna see right here. This is a flip-flop full on the beam, super difficult.
Hang on.
And you know, to give you an example, that type of move we will be seeing a lot of back in December when the Romanians brought their young team. 5 out of the 6 young girls were doing that type of element on the beam, so you know that that's the trend.
Little bit tentative here and there.
Kind of strange to see in the stands after the competition, the practice rounds the other day, Crystal Uzlak signing autographs at age 14. Hasn't done much, you know, beyond the two junior championships. The little girls in the audience certainly know who she is, but that is how quickly word spreads about the youngsters, and that is unfortunate for Uzlak.
And one of the changes that they've made with the code of points is they said that they wouldn't crucify the athletes and take the full 5/10 deduction. That should only be 0.3. We'll see what the judges do.
But this is not the level of gymnastics that she's capable of.
Ah, really nervous now.
Yeah. When it all goes right, it just looks so brilliant. But when things start going wrong and you're on 4 inches of balance beam.
Well, she said herself she was concerned with all the cameras in her face, and you know, she'd never been exposed to that before.
Much different arena for the 14-year-old Uzlak. Again, their first international meet at the big-time level. reigning two-time defending junior champion, has had her struggles today. And the score for Blaine Wilson on the P-bars has just come in, and it's an impressive 9.3. So this would be a pretty good pair of dual titles that Blaine is working on. Of course, the five national championships. It looks like Blaine Wilson is on his way to his fourth American Cup title. That's a pretty good duo of prestigious gymnastics events. Back in a moment. Now looking at Crystal Uzlak, smile on her face after she received an 8.875 on her beam routine. That'll keep her behind her American teammate, Ashley Kelly. Just got a little talking to by Donna Strauss, trying to encourage her. Been a little bit of a disappointing coming out, but only 14 years old.
That's right. She's actually too young to even compete in the next World Championships. Donna Strauss said that this is not just a stepping stone. This would be a gigantic leap for her.
Well, resuming the men's competition, we shift over to Alexander Barish on the P-bars. And look at his line today.
And he needs actually an 11.6 to overtake Blaine Wilson, which I don't
the
think.
New quota points, is that, no?
I don't think it's gonna happen, not today. And right here, you see that mount? I'm actually having a conversation with his coach, Igor Korbchinsky, a former world champion, and he was telling me the routine, and I said, Igor, you can't do that. That's an illegal element now. And he goes, you're kidding.
Well, that's one of the points that some of the coaches were making, is that they've arrived here thinking that certain things were okay. And Igor Korbchinsky being one of those coaches that has been making changes right here at this competition. So they're still changing the routines.
Tim Daggett, the true gymnastic sportsman.
Oh.
And they're right there. You see two elements done very poorly. One of them is a specific required skill that he has to do now that he didn't have to do not even one time in the last 4 years, and he just is not practiced enough with it. His coach, Igor Korbchinsky, says that parallel bars is the big problem for him, for Barish at this point in time.
Korbchinsky, pretty good gymnast in his own right.
All-around champion at the 1989 World Championships, member of the unified team in 1992 that won the gold medal.
And now tutoring the 23-year-old Barish as we go over to the beam in the women's competition. Little look at Zamo, continues to lead, but as we mentioned earlier, the gap has diminished significantly, just 6/1000ths of a point ahead of Laura Martinez of Spain as we begin this rotation.
Well, she certainly knows what her job is here. I asked her what she planned to do while in Florida, just her second time in the U.S. She said, well, let's see. First, my priority is to win the American Cup. Secondly, I'm going to Disney World.
And third, do as much shopping as possible.
She's gotten that in already. This is pretty much the same balance beam routine that we saw from the Olympic Games. She hasn't really altered it that much. I find her style to be very, very quick at times, sometimes almost jerky. And the balance beam was one of the events that the Russians had a great deal of problems with in the team competition. In fact, she said it was really disappointing. They had three mistakes, and she felt that was really instrumental in them losing the gold medal to the Romanians.
Have we mentioned femininity yet today?
Well, it's a new component for the women's quota points, and what they actually have on both balance beam and floor exercise is a category for artistry.
And again, these are new in the
yes,
new quota
they
points.
Are. I'm actually happy to see it because I think it will set some athletes apart, because there certainly are some athletes that are more entertaining than others, and they do a better job in presenting. And the last time I looked at the quota points, it did say women's artistic gymnastics, so that should be a big part of it.
Another solid routine for Zamo.
Well, her two gold medals at the Olympics will definitely put her in the record books. She said her most memorable experience outside of competition at the Games was meeting another Russian legend at the Olympic Games in the Olympic Village, Karelin. She got to meet him, and she found out that she shares the same birthday
as Alexander Karelin, the man who was, before Rulon Gardner, the United States beat him at the Olympics, was unbeatable. But that's an image to conjure up.
Yeah.
The giant man they've nicknamed the Beast, Alexander Karelin, and the tiny Yelena Zamolachikova. Tim, you're always full of trivia. The same birthdays. More gymnastics in a moment. Yelena Zamolachikova, the leader throughout so far, but it is Laura Martinez who continues the chase. The balance beam score for Zamo, 9.075. And Alexander Barish, his P-bar routine, produced a score of 8.05. And again, there's no one really putting the pressure on Blaine Wilson at all. Well, recently there's been a change at the top of the gymnastics hierarchy, at least as far as the women are concerned. And for more on that, we go down to Beth Ruyak. Beth.
Well, Dan, people will know the name Bella Caroli and Marta Caroli. They know as both a coach and the head coach of the 96 Olympic team. Now add the title of national team coordinator. Marta, hello. And what's the one thing you want to do for the women's program in this job?
Well, right now we are in a process of a strategic planning for the new quadrennium. And this is a so much better situation than trying to do quick fix-ups in the Olympic year. Our main goal to bring back the U.S. women gymnastics where it belongs are the medal contender situation. And we're planning this to reach our goals, 2003 World Championships in Indianapolis, and then certainly the Olympics.
A key for the program is going to be unifying everybody, coaches and athletes. How do you do that?
Absolutely, that's number one goal. And for that, we have to start the work right now. We have to make sure that all of our gymnasts will get to the capability to handle the same workload of the workout, to be capable to do the number of repetition of the routines necessary to be successful. And based on this, to be extremely confident team. And we're working on physical and mental parts. Mentally, we want to prepare the girls to be able to put the team goal in front of individual goals and to understand that their contribution is great.
Thank you, Marta. We'll go back to you, Dan. She always said that Bella had the spotlight, but she's got it now.
Certainly does. Taking over for Bella, who held the same position, took it over less than a year before the run-up to Sydney, but now in the background as Marta takes over, and now there is Sean Townsend of the United States. Maybe he's the only guy left that can put some pressure on his on the leader, Wilson, huh?
Actually needs a 9.75 to move ahead of Blaine, which is possible. He does a very difficult exercise. That a new move right there.
We're going to see that one more time.
Little bit of a struggle right here.
In a tuck position.
Sean actually has a new coach in addition to Kevin Majaika. Rustam Sharapov, an Olympic champion on this event, now working in Houston at the National Center.
He knows how to stick those landings.
Well, not going to be enough to move ahead of Blaine Wilson, but certainly showing, once again, parallel bars. We saw an 8.05 from Barish, and showing just how difficult this new code of points is with all these requirements. That's not going to be near the 9.75. He needs to overtake Blaine Wilson, but definitely showing that he's in the game at this point.
And showing off the guns there. Townsend, kind of a story of just glad to be here, make the Olympic team in Sydney, but as 2004 approaches, Tim, this guy could be one of the main figures for the American men.
Well, you look at the body positions and what he actually has, his assets, and he is very well suited for this code of points, and he does this a lot too, which isn't bad, sticking the landing.
And to follow up on the interview that Beth had with Marta, again, no medals for both the men and the women at the 2000 Olympics. It was a very disappointing performance, not only for the women, but for the men as well.
Camila Coman of Brazil.
Well, so maybe Sean Townsend will have something to do with the more success in 2004. As you look at Martinez again trying to put the pressure on Zamo, she needs better than a score of 9.081 to take over the lead from Zamo.
And
here she is on the beam.
Yeah, Dan, that's a possibility, because even though her start value is somewhere around a 9.7, If she maxes out on that score, she could very well score in that range. Jesus Carballo, her coach, said if there was one downfall to Laura as a gymnast or performer, it would be her problems with consistency, but we certainly haven't seen that here.
And the score for Townsend, 9.65, a big score for Townsend. And that's going to keep him in second solidly.
And that puts Blaine Wilson in a position he has very rarely felt at this American Cup. He is, of course, going for unprecedented fourth in a row. He will be the only athlete, male or female, to ever win four titles if he's successful today. But right now, Sean putting a lot of pressure on him. And I have to tell you, if I have to handicap it at this point in time, Sean Townsend, he's stronger than Blaine on high bar.
We'll see how it unfolds, and we'll also see how the women's competition unfolds as Zamo and that young 16-year-old, Laura Martinez, continue to compete down the stretch as well. And remember, Martinez, an excellent tumbler, good on the floor exercise. This could be pretty good drama on the women's side as well.
And she will tumble right onto the beam. A round off back somersault, turn her body around and do a backflip and just land on that beam.
She has a lot of variety here in this routine. Whoa. This routine is actually loaded with acrobatic skills. Again, remember, the judges are looking for an artistic flair in the routine. It's not just about acro skills.
And right there you see a static hold position that is now required in balance beam.
Well, I don't know what you guys think. She gets best costume. It's early, but a lot of Spanish flair to that leotard.
She's going to have to do more than just keep it close after this first round, because into the last round, of course, Zamo will end on floor, as will Laura.
She's actually had some questionable mistakes already. And again, it's important to point out that artistic component of the routine is actually theirs to lose. The judges can deduct up to 0.3. if they don't feel that there was enough presentation or enough elegance and beauty in the routine. Bit of a struggle.
Probably will not get the 9.081 to pull ahead of Zamo, so Martinez is going to fall back a little bit, perhaps. Well, we mentioned the Romanian women are not here, but there is a Romanian representative for the men, and he's Marian Dragulescu, 20 years old. Of course, a participant for the Romanian men in the Olympics. They finished sixth in the team competition. This is Marian's second American Cup, fourth last year. And a look at his line as he gets set for the P-bars.
And I tell you, watching him in training, it was like, ouch, ooh, that's gotta hurt. Every turn, I was like, what's this guy thinking? A pounding event. Frankly, most of the guys out there really aren't ready to do all that. Here comes the first one right here. This is new for him. He'll keep his legs straight. Oh
well, he did.
That was an ouch.
He did mention that this was going to be an event that he would struggle with, this along with high bar.
Right as he hit Danny, he went, what am I doing? And right there, he actually had to kind of pull out of an element. He was supposed to do another pounding skill to his upper arms.
So is there masculinity in the new quota points for the men? If there was, he might get a tenth there, huh?
And this is a big, this huge mistake. 5/10, you're sitting on the apparatus and losing a requirement as well.
The aches and pains of the new quota points.
Yeah, he's going to look at that score and he's going to go, that's really not worth it the way my arms feel right now.
Dragulescu, who to that point was putting the most pressure on the Americans. But there is the score for Martinez, 8.762. So she'll fall a little further behind. Zamo the leader. And there she is, Yelena Zamolatchikova of Russia, on her way to perhaps her first Visa American Cup title. Well, the women have just one more rotation, the floor exercise left in this Visa American Cup as we continue live from Orlando, Florida, and downtown at the TD Waterhouse Center. You're looking at the leader, Zamo. And we expect that she will win this American Cup title. And Blaine Wilson is in pretty good shape over Sean Townsend, his American teammate.
Yeah, the only person that can win this besides Blaine is Sean Townsend. It is just too big of a margin, 47-1 to 47 even for Townsend, and Lopez almost 2 points in back of both of them.
So it looks like Wilson's prediction is going to come true.
I was going to say he was right on the money when he mentioned the fact that he and Sean were well ahead of the rest of the game.
Yeah, second place is worth $10,000, so it could be a nice payday here in Orlando for Wilson and Townsend. Who will win the title, though? That to be decided. Zamo getting ready for the final warm-up for the women as they get set for the floor exercise. We go down to Beth.
Okay, Dan, let me give you a couple little tidbits. I'm thinking back to practice, and Elena had some pretty gritty practices. Her first floor pass, which you'll see in just a bit, she fought for and landed on her knees and almost her nose 3 times in a row and kept fighting for it, finally landing it. It's a very, very difficult pass. So watch for that coming up. Meanwhile, I'm remembering Blaine Wilson saying that if this code had been the only thing that his future of gymnastics depended on, he would have quit. His whole game plan today was to have fun and find a new experience. And everyone on the floor is saying, do you see the new Blaine? Do you see Blaine being back better than ever? So that's the news from down here. And if it holds true, we're going to see these two take their American Cup titles. Back to you, Dan.
Thank you, Beth. Yeah, in the words of Blaine Wilson on the Code of Points, he said, I think they stink.
That would be a Blaine saying, yep.
Very PC, that Blaine.
But then he's like, well, you know, with all the new moves, it's kind of energized me, and that's really kept me going as well. So
the only thing he was really excited about was rings, which is certainly his event. And he said, you know, I've looked at it with new eyes because I'd go to the gym and think, gee, I wonder what new strength elements I can come up with.
And he said he feels like a kid. He says it's ironic that he's been doing gymnastics for so long and he felt so beat up after the Olympic Games, both mentally and physically. Now he says he's stronger, he's lighter, he's healthier than he's been in as long as he can remember.
And he's back in his native Columbus, Ohio, living with his sister as he's returned to Ohio State University. Has about a year or so to go before he's expected to get his degree in psychology. Says he's got everyone in his family in Columbus. That's the only drawback a little bit. He says dad tends to come out
a little too often.
Every day he comes over. Take a look at the women's standings with just the final rotation left. The floor exercise, Zamolatchikova with a little better than 3/10 lead now over Martinez, who had closed it to within 6/1000 after the previous rotation. And Ashley Kelly of the United States, this has been a pretty impressive performance, especially when you consider the late notice she got coming here to Orlando. There she is.
Yeah, I think that might be a good thing because she didn't have time to psych herself out. She came here to do a job. And as I said at the top of the broadcast, she's a focused athlete. She's going to take this opportunity and use it for experience.
I know, can't you see Crystal Uzelac on the flip side, you know, training months. My gosh, I've got the American Cup. It's my first big meet. You've got all this pressure to build up, and Kelly finds out maybe a couple of days beforehand, let's go.
No time to think.
Her coach, Christy Kraft, told me that the good thing about this is she just doesn't get it. She doesn't know how important this is, and she says, I'm not going to tell her.
There is Christy Kraft. And there is Marta Caroli, the new national team coordinator, comparing some notes.
Let's see.
Perhaps talking about the, no, Code of Points? No. Well, Blaine Wilson has the high bar left. As you take a look at his 1/10 of a point lead over Sean Townsend. Steve Lopez, the defending champion, Eric Lopez, excuse me, has made quite a comeback. He at one point was in the 8th position, but is now looming there in 3rd. And there's a little bit of prize money in the 3rd spot as well, $5,000 that Eric Lopez could take back to his native Havana, Cuba, and celebrate a little bit with his new son, Eric, 2 weeks old. Big question is, will he complete the phone call back to Cuba? We'll have to wait and see. There is Christy Kraft and Ashley Kelly.
And they're getting ready for floor exercise, and Christy said one of the elements that they are a little bit concerned about is a full twisting double somersault. It's the first meet she has ever competed
this
year.
She just
learned it. No, nobody's over there. Go move around.
Now on the horizontal bar for the USA, Blaine Wilson.
Now Blaine Wilson. Is this going to be the fourth Visa American Cup title to go along with five national championships?
Well, when the code initially came out, Blaine thought that high bar was a disaster for him, that it just wasn't going to work. But then, just like with the tax code, you kind of find these little loopholes. And because he'll admit,
interesting analogy.
That's how
there.
The guys work.
He'll
it,
admit
huh?
that this is not his best event, and he doesn't do the major release skills, but he's able to put elements together. And that is the critical thing. That's how you get a lot of this bonus.
This was the event that caused him a lot of grief at the Olympic Games as well.
Right here, a little bit of a problem. Supposed to do that in combination and actually left one of the skills out. Here's his release skill, very nicely done. One arm giant, and he'll combine this once again, putting difficult elements together. Gets him extra points. Dismount.
Well, there it is. Final performance of the afternoon for Blaine Wilson. Sat out last year's American Cup, still feeling the effects of the shoulder surgery. And by the way, he says that'll have to be cleaned out again before he competes for too much longer. So Blaine Wilson will now post the score and wait to see if anybody can catch him. The best guy who has a chance is his teammate, Sean Townsend, right there. He's coming up. First big meet after the Olympics. It was disappointing for Blaine Wilson in Sydney in 2000, but his final score, a 9.2 on the high bar, and now he will sit and wait. But he has not put himself out of reach by any means from his teammate Sean Townsend, has he?
No, he hasn't, and Sean actually has the goods to get this job done. He has an amazing sequence planned, but I don't know. If I was Sean right now, I'd be talking to that guy right over there, my coach, Kevin Majaika, and I'd be saying, you know, I don't think I need to do it all to win this thing.
I want the 15,000.
A 9.3 will tie him with Blaine Wilson, so he needs better than a 9.3 to win this competition. He's coming up a little later. He's the fourth man to go in this sixth and final rotation. Next up for the women, Zamo, here in the floor exercise, which anchors their competition. And it was Zamo who lengthened the lead a little bit over Laura Martinez of Spain, who is yet to go down the list a little bit for the women as well.
Well, and this is by far the hardest floor team we're going to see in this competition. She's just packed with difficulty. Beth had alluded to that first tumbling pass, which we've seen her practice over and over again, crashing and burning, but just coming back time and time again, finally landing it. It's very difficult, and in fact, it's one of those super E elements that I talked about a while back, and it will give her 3 tenths. She's definitely got the goods here.
And again, when we asked her, Tim, it was actually you who asked her what her most satisfying experience was out of Sydney. She said, hey, floor exercise. She won the gold, and that was one of the events where she earned her way in.
Big pass. This is it right here. No problem.
Again, remember, the judges have made a big change here. They're actually going to reward for artistry, an athlete that can be entertaining, can project their personal style, show beauty and elegance all combined in one. They don't want to see robotic choreography.
We'll be right back.
Well, they want to see the artistry, as Elfie said, but they also want to see someone jump like that. She does it as well as anybody in the world.
Zamo, the gold medalist from Sydney. And in all likelihood, after that, we'll add the Visa American Cup title to her resume. Now the bronze medalist in the high bar from Sydney, Alexander Barish.
Actually, bronze in the all-around.
Alexander Barish.
One of the biggest disappointments for Barish at the Olympic Games was not just winning a medal, but winning this event, high bar, at the Games. He, in a lot of ways, was favored, and you'll see why right off the top.
Yeah, he was the gold medalist at the European Championships, which were held just shortly before.
And nobody flies like this guy and does it so perfectly. Watch this first one.
Wow. Oh. Didn't look like he was going to hang on.
That was amazing. Just barely got his fingers out of the bar.
This is what I love about men's high bar, and this is what the audience appreciates, the high flying skills.
Yeah, you know you're really good, like I said, when they change the rules, they make it way harder, and your routine still gets the job done.
This guy needs a nickname, Air Barish.
Oh, a little bit of a problem there. That was an amazing save, though. Only the dismount remaining. Double twisting, double somersault, and an incredible exercise. No doubt about it, he is going to be in the hunt for any championships when it comes to high bar for basically as long as this guy competes. He can fly with the best of them.
A little congratulatory handshake there from Townsend. And again, Townsend is upcoming. Will he have the goods to pass Blaine Wilson and win the Visa American Cup title?
Now on the floor.
A happy Yelena Zamolachikova with a 9.325 on the floor, and that is going to put some big pressure on Laura Martinez of Spain, who's going to need better than a 9.644 to take away the title from Zamo. Not likely. That is yet to come. In the meantime, the drama on the men's side of things, where Sean Townsend needs better than a 9.3 on the high bar to take the title away from Blaine Wilson. This would be by far the most illustrious title on the resume of young Sean Townsend. Is this the routine that's going to get it for him?
Well, it can get it for him. There's no doubt about that. He does a potential release sequence that is huge by any standard. He'll do one of those tricky combinations to get 5/10 in bonus right here. This one arm, he's got to connect this to this inside skill. And actually made a little bit of a change there. Here comes the major release sequence. Going to try to do two in a row, and way too close on that first one.
Can he recover from here?
I don't think it's going to happen. Let's see, he actually added that in because he had left it out early on. I don't think he's got it.
Probably not going to happen this time for Sean Townsend.
You know, he's planning to do this major release sequence.
Hey,
he was supposed
man.
To do what's
deal,
called
what
a Gaylord 2 right after that first release where he flew through the air, was too close to the bar, wouldn't have had the swing to get it over. But actually, earlier on, left or changed an element.
And Blaine Wilson, knowing at this point that he's the American Cup champion for the fourth time, although we don't have the official score yet for Townsend. By the way, Barish turned in a 9.5 on the high bar. And over to the floor exercise, and now this is Laura Martinez, again, who needs better than a 9.644 to overtake Zama.
And I think that's going to be a pretty tall order, especially in this first competition of the year, an international meet with the new rules. She doesn't have the same difficulty in tumbling as Zamo.
Thank you. Nice version of La Cucaracha here, huh? A little Spanish flair continuing for Martinez.
Coach Jesus Carballo says his plans for his Spanish team are not for the upcoming World Championships in 2001, but he set his sights for 2003 when the World Championships come to the U.S. in Indianapolis.
She put a bit of a scare into Zamo for a while when she pulled within that 0.06 of a point, but in the end, not quite good enough for Martinez, as Zamo is going to win this title.
Did a very nice job today, though.
In the meantime, the score for Sean Townsend, not good enough as we expected, a 9.2 on the high bar. So Blaine Wilson wins his fourth FISA American Cup title. Townsend's going to be in second. Back live at the Visa American Cup in Orlando, and a smiling Laura Martinez, and she has good reason to. After completing her final event, the floor exercise, which produced a good score of 9.462, but it comes up a little short to pass Zamo. She needed better than a 9.6.
Yeah, she has nothing to be disappointed about today. A really wonderful job, and already adapting very well. This Spanish team, I tell you, they are going to be a force to be reckoned with in women's gymnastics, coming off of such a successful Olympic Games for them and showing that they are not stopping there. They're going to build upon it. She showed that to me today, at least.
Again, Spain finishing fifth as a team in the 2000 Olympics, and it was Martinez who finished 13th in the all-around. Also, it's been a very successful day for that 17-year-old, Ashley Kelly, again coming in on Thursday late, realizing only on Wednesday that she was going to be a part of this field.
And her coach, Christy Kraft, said it's just one more step along the way to where she wants to eventually be this year. That would be making the World Championship team for the United States.
Well, coming up, we'll have one last look at Ashley Kelly and her American teammate, Crystal Uzlak. That's when we return to Orlando for more gymnastics, but we go back to our New York studio now for an update with Ahmad Rashad. The 2001 Visa American Cup is brought to you by Visa. It's everywhere you want to be. By Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. Remember, there's no wrong way to eat a Reese's. And by Prudential, your rock-solid choice for insurance, investments, real estate, and financial services. As we wind down the competition here at the American Cup, Ashley Kelly, and she is in a pretty heated battle here for third. She'll be on the floor exercise in just a moment to see if she can occupy that third spot. A look at her line today, very solid. And over to the high bar as the men wrap up their competition. Marian Dragulescu finds himself in a bit of a battle for third, but he's a long shot really to get that third spot.
Yeah, he is, and he's got a lot of very difficult elements planned, and quite frankly, he was not all that successful in training. First one comes right off the top, and it's a very, very intricate element where he has to land near the handstand, and it's followed by a major release skill. I didn't see him complete it the whole time he was here. And he goes over the bar. That is not what he planned on doing. Nice release skill of Kovacs here. This routine works fairly well with the new code of points, but has to upgrade the difficulty a little bit, but a great landing.
Little up and down afternoon for Dragulescu. needed better than a 9.125 for that third spot.
It was a clean routine, but I'm not sure that he's going to have enough difficulty to bring in that score.
There is the champion, Zamo.
The weight is so difficult.
Next on floor is Ashley Kelly, who needs an 8.606 for third place, right behind Laura Martinez of Spain.
Dan, it's so hard to believe that about a year ago, she aspired to just compete as a high school gymnast. Her coach, Christy Kraft, said it took some time to convince her that she was good enough to be at this level.
Right off the bat, she'll do her new element, piked full twisting, double somersault.
That's a shame.
Yeah, that hand touched.
She's still in.
Just barely in.
With the new rules and putting that hand down, it's going to be very, very difficult for that to happen.
One area that she will impress the judges in. She'll impress the judges with that artistry component. I think she did a really nice job selling the routine.
And you know, the mount, that full in, she definitely had it. It was up in the air high enough. She just kind of, she slows down at the end, quite frankly, and doesn't keep pulling. And probably thought she was going to over-rotate.
And this is one of the skills that they've actually upgraded. It's one of the old skills that we saw years and years ago. Some of the athletes had still been competing this move, but they've upgraded it to an E element.
And you see that hand hitting the floor, and that is a major deduction.
The same technique what you're using all the time.
You know what? Yeah. There are some good things. We're stronger through the routine.
Yeah.
I'm going to put my money on this one.
It's okay. Make a mistake. You can scratch it off.
That's for sure. You can't get it back.
Right. It's okay. Come on, Crystal.
A little dual coaching there from the new national team coordinator, Marta Caroli, and Christy Kraft. See the tears welling up in her eyes a little bit, even though this could be definitely termed a successful event for Ashley. You can see how distraught she is after her final event.
Another one of her coaches, Jean-Luc Caron, husband to the head coach, Christy Kraft. He was a great gymnast from the French team back in the 80s. So disappointing when you come so close, but she made a lot of progress in her career.
Yeah, and remember, this is only her second international event. She's still young.
Now the score for Kelly, an 8.375, as she tumbles into fifth place at the moment. Now Crystal Uzlak trying to finish with an exclamation point here. It's been a definite step up to the big time here at the American Cup. She needs an 8.9, a little better than that for third.
Yeah, definitely possible, but struggled a tiny bit, eh, Tim, in the practices the other day.
Right here on this Arabian double front.
Tough pass.
Wow.
No problem today. Definitely a another routine that's going to entertain the audiences and judges.
Well, if she stays on the gymnastics scene with the poise and the presence that she has, a lot of people are going to like Crystal Huslack. There's no doubt about that.
Very nice.
She's got it back.
Remember, she struggled on her last event, the beam, which is her best event. But no signs of that whatsoever here. She's had all day long.
Some gymnasts have it, and Huslack has it. I mean, you could tell how she just energized this crowd.
That is her coach, Donna Strauss.
It was so good.
And another coach, Robin, from the Parquettes organization.
It's been around for 30 years. There is Bill Strauss. He and his wife, Donna, started it way back nearly 3 decades ago. We were talking about it earlier, Tim.
That was a great job.
One of the most longest enduring gymnastics clubs in history of this country. The Parquettes. And they have a prize pupil in Huslack. We'll get her score in just a moment. Meantime, we'll wrap up the defending champion, Eric Lopez. And he's a part of that group battling for the third spot. Needs 7.9 for third.
And that's obviously very doable, but I asked him where he struggles with this code of points, and he said, it doesn't matter what code of points it is, I'm going to struggle on high
Always
bar.
On high bar.
Big release skill coming right here.
Oh.
Wow.
Not even close.
Yikes.
Actually pulled out halfway through that element that was supposed to be a full twisting front somersault, and
he
like
was
I
hurting
said,
earlier after the floor exercise routine, kind of banged his ankle a little bit, and that didn't feel too good right there.
So now as a gymnast, not only does he lose the bonus for that element, you tell your athletes this over and over again, some crazy stuff right here. He loses the element, loses the bonus, loses the required skill of letting go of the bar.
Yikes.
That was an adventure.
And he almost lost the landing, too.
That just wasn't in the cards from the get-go.
Well, and he told us at practice the other day that this was really...
Look at that. Just yikes.
But he didn't expect that.
And get your arms over your head when you're... Got your back to the bar and your head's coming towards it. That's pretty scary stuff. He was supposed to do another half turn and just knew that he was way off.
Unfortunate. It had been a pretty good comeback for Lopez, digging himself out of the eighth spot. In the meantime, Huslack in third with a score of 9.325. So that's a pretty good comeback. She just kind of hung around and hung around and finally passed Ashley Kelly.
Well, the coach, Bill Strauss, said one of her greatest qualities is being able to leave a mistake behind and move on.
That's exactly what 14-year-old Crystal Huslack did, and that's the kind of fortitude that you often can't coach. And as you look ahead to 2004, it's a great quality to have.
Yeah, it's actually a very good group of athletes that the U.S. has.
And it's Huslack who finishes behind the winner, Zamolachikova of Russia. She wins it. Laura Martinez of Spain finishes second. And there is Zamo. And we will continue to hear her name, Zamolachikova, or Zamo, whatever version. You can bet in the next few years leading up to Athens. Definitely a part of her goal is to get back to Athens.
Orlando Gymnastics. Orlando Metro Gymnastics.
Well,
more to come.
The American men went 1-2 in this competition, and with Blaine Wilson and Sean Townsend, here's Beth Ruiak.
Thank you, Dan. First of all, here with Blaine, 4 times now you've done this. You said you wanted to go 1-2. Did you think that maybe you'd be number two?
Yeah, I mean, Sean was good. He looked good all week in practice, and I knew it was going to come down to a real close
real close competition.
New year, new code, new strategy here. How was it out there?
It was good. It started out a little nerve-wracking on pommel horse, but it's always hard to start on pommel horse. But you just keep going through, and we picked up some momentum towards the end.
Momentum is right. We got to bring the guy with momentum in here. Congratulations, Sean. What a
Thank
meet.
You. Thank you.
Did you know how close the scores were? Was Kevin talking to you about it?
I glanced up there and saw that it was pretty close between me and Blaine, so.
You've told us in the interview we all want to beat Blaine. You really wanted to beat Blaine. Did you think it might come in the American Cup?
Actually, I didn't. I just wanted to get through this meet and have fun. And before the meet, me and Blaine had a little talk, and we said, let's make this meet just between me and you, nobody else. And we did that.
Okay. You were saying, show me the money. You guys got it. Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right. I'm going to let you shake his hand and walk over here. Congratulations,
Thank
Elena.
You. Thank you very much.
What is it to you to win the American Cup?
For me, I'm very happy because it's my first competition in America. It's a serious competition. Very happy it's a medal for me.
It's a medal for you. Congratulations. And Dan, that's a big step. That's a big interview in English for Elena Zamolachkova. Congratulations there.
Thank you very much.
Okay, back to you, Dan Helfy.
Congratulations to both of you, Beth. Nice job with Zamo, the winner. Just her second time in the United States. Had made one brief trip to New Jersey, but for the first time competitively comes here and wins it. Blaine Wilson and Sean Townsend go 1-2 in the men's competition. Now, Blaine Wilson, still America's best gymnast, even though he had a rough start. Blaine persevered and went on to win and hold off his teammate Sean Townsend, who had just an unbelievable start in the floor exercise.
Like I said before, it fits again, Kerr Powell.
Different kind of day this year for the defending champion, Eric Lopez of Cuba. It's going to be a long plane trip home to Havana. In the meantime, Zamo impressed us again and left us with little doubt that she'll be a factor again in Athens in 2004.
She came into this competition as the favorite and didn't disappoint.
And how about Ashley Kelly on short notice coming in? Sean Townsend gives Blaine Wilson a run, and Kelly was impressive. There's Marta Caroli in her first big meet as the national team coordinator. But it was all Zamo stage for all of us here on a gymnastics crew at NBC. Dan Hicks saying so long from the American Cup.